Okay, next video. Hey, what's up, you guys? Today, we are going to be playing The Escapist. This is a game I obviously had to play because it is an 8-bit game, and I love 8-bit games. And also, it's a thing that's kind of trending right now. And I'm kind of near the end of the trend, but still, I want to check out the game. Seems pretty cool, seems kind of fun, so decided to pick it up, and I'm going to, you know, play with you guys. Because I have to join the bandwagon of all YouTubers playing this game at all. So, let's look into this game, because I've been wanting to play it for a while, like I said. Alright, so I already started a game. I'll, you know, go make a new one like I'm showing doing now. But anyways, we will play as Maru. The characters don't really matter, but as you can see here, there's different prisons we can pick from, and basically these prisons are different levels. For our purpose, we're going to play on very easy, because I do not feel like I can do the hard level, because I am a noob, and I haven't even understood this game at all. So, we'll select this game, and, after we select this map, there is something else you can do with this game that's actually pretty cool and unique, and that is you can, rename the characters. It's pretty cool. If you want to name one Officer Douchebag, or, Faggot McGee, or, Dick Butt, I don't know. You guys are probably really interesting and creative. You can think of your own name. But basically, I will keep my people the default name, because I have no time to actually go around and name every single one of those prisoners. So, as this loads, never mind. As you can see here, at the bottom, Dear Maru, welcome to the Center Perks, the most comfortable low-security prison in the county. On behalf of all of the staff here, we wish you a happy and relaxing visit. Should you get bored of the complimentary cable TV, we pride ourselves in many other engaging activities around the grounds. Warden Dean Hall. Oh, that's nice of him. I butchered half that letter. That's very nice of him. I don't think prisons usually do that. But anyways, like I was saying, we have a schedule to follow. And if we don't follow that schedule, we get noticed and we get in trouble. So from the first hour, I believe, is roll call, as it shows here. I don't know much about this game at all. I know the basics. That's what I'm kind of explaining it. It's all a very weird game. We just stand here, and just that's pretty much it, I guess. And we just kind of listen to them. And also, there are shakedowns for, to see who has contraband. Because contraband is a bad thing, obviously. What is that guy? He looks like the guy running past on the left. What is he? The warden may be visiting today. Probably not, because wardens hate us. The warden hates us. The first period is breakfast. So we will go and eat our breakfast. And also, another weird thing about this game is that people randomly beat the shit out of each other. So that is interesting. Don't know why. It's prison. I guess that's the reason. But, yeah. Also, the other day, I was exploring new games for Xbox One, and I saw The Escapist came out on Xbox One. I'm like, hell yeah, good for them. This game is expanding. It's getting out there. It's getting known. I'm pretty proud of them, even though they're not my kid. But still, I'm pretty psyched. I was thinking about picking it up on Xbox One, but I don't see a purpose in it if I already have it. So right now, we are in free period, and basically what that means, it's, we can do whatever the hell we want. We can go work out, we can go to the laundry room in here if you really want to clean clothes, you can go talk to people that visit, go on the internet, you gain intelligence, and basically you grow different attributes throughout the game. Strength, swiftness, I think, speed, and intelligence. You can also go into your cell and look at what's in your desk, and also you can stand on top of it and go in the air ducts if you have the right materials. And then that was shown in the tutorial. Also, you can go into other people's, you can go to other people's desks and see what they have. And usually there's contraband and other goodies you can take, but if you get caught, you're gonna get the shit beat out of you. It's prison, remember that. It is a realistic prison simulator, I think. That's what they call it, and I agree. Very interesting. Free period usually lasts like 1 or 2 hours, I forget. But, this is in your cell, Maru. God. You did. Nails, I don't know what we can craft. I don't know what I can craft though. That's the thing. Huh. Okay. So I guess we will continue on. Oh. Oh, he just got knocked out. Okay, carry on. Carry on. Was that blood on the ground? Ew. You just basically mess around for a free period and then eventually you have your job right? And you have lunch and dinner and all that stuff. It's really interesting. And at the top left, I will explain what those are. We have the money, obviously money. That's how we can buy things for other prisoners, like materials and whatnot. The hearts, obviously, is your health. And the police officer there, the security guard, that is your kind of how much they're watching you. We're going to lunch now. That's cool. And also the energy bar, which is the electricity sign, is at 17% right now. Excuse my English. And that means is how worked up we are, how much energy we have. If we have 100%, that means we are pooped out. We have 0%, we're ready to go. So I will sit down here and eat my lunch for an hour, because that's realistic. You sit and eat lunch for an hour. I only get half an hour in school. But anyways, I think after this, we have to do our job. And my job, on very easy level, our job is laundry, doing the laundry. And that is a very interesting job. So let's get to it. Yeah, let's go. Turns out my bro was a sis. Oh, these prisoners say really, really, really weird things. Ugh. So I guess we will go to the job in here and collect outfits from the dirty laundry trolley and put them in the washing machines. Basically, you get the dirty outfits, you put them in the washing machine, take out the clean ones. Oh god, these guys are fighting. I'm going back in. You take them out, you put them in the clean area. And also with this, we can take a security outfit, a clean security outfit. And that would be very, what's the word I'm looking for? Very malicious? No, I don't know about malicious. Very deviant. I don't know, very evil. We can disguise ourselves as a security guard. And we can put that as part of our plan to escape. Which is the point of the game, escape the prison. And just so interesting. Ugh. This is a very boring job. This is probably the worst job I can ever do. And the prison, the cops have their eye on me, 85%, it's probably because I have the security outfits in my, you know, inventory, so they're like, the hell you doing? So, yeah. Huh. This is very tedious. Oh, I reached my job quota, and basically what that, basically what that means is that I can go f*** around and do whatever the hell I want. I am gonna go pump some metal, as the buff guys say, and I am going to work my strength, so that will help me in my escape from the prison. And ooh, that guy was wearing a security hat. Well, that was weird. I hate the animation for when they take a piss. Ugh, it's gross. What's the next period? I forget. I think it ends in like 20 seconds or 20. I think in this game, every second is 2 minutes in this game. I think that's how it works. I don't know. Oh god, someone's getting beat. Oh, WTH. Oh my god. Oh, who won? Oh! Carter. Psh. Oh, that guy's on the ground. I got this. I got this. Ugh. So, what is there to talk about? Oh yeah. How did I get 50 bucks? Oh, because I did my job. I got a pop filter. And I guess that's pretty cool. It actually makes my voice sound much, much more cleaner and doesn't make that noise, or that's not what it does really, but it makes my voice more clear for you guys to hear. And I might be talking a little loud or too low. I'm trying to experiment really with it at this point, because I don't know what I sound like after this recording. Exercise, push it to the limit. And also I got a new mouse, a new gaming mouse, which is pretty nice. Oh god, the showers. Also, the showers decrease our energy, or increase our energy, which is pretty cool. Who's got the soap? Who's got the soap? In the shower, you just sit here and you get energy back, and you just try not to get raped in the shower unless they really want it. I don't know if any of these guys want it. They want me. Am I wearing a towel? You want some of this? You want some of this? Yeah, I know you want some of this, gay boy. You want some of this. I know you do. Any of you want any of this, you just come to my cell. Oh, yeah. Okay. Oh, God. They want my booty. They're fighting over my booty. Okay. Ugh, okay. So, like I was saying, I got a new mouse, which is very, very comfortable. And I actually have to put that in the description now, don't I? No, I don't. Well, I'm going to anyways. The mouse is in the description. It's very comfy. You can change the speed, the sensitivity speed of the mouse, which is actually really cool. So, that's something. And also, I got a scissor arm stand, and basically, it's like a, It's like a bendable stand for my microphone. And I also got a new microphone, a Samson C01U, I think it's called, I believe. Hold on. Yeah, something like that. I'll put that in the description too, because I got rid of my Blue Yeti because I did not see why that is. I didn't like it. But also, back to this, the arms. This is our arm stand. Free time now, yay. But like I was saying, back to the arm stand. It doesn't work with my microphone, but my friend Shayla's Hero has a adapter screw to it, a female male screw, and I think it might be the right one I need, because it looks like it'll fit my mic, and I am getting my hopes up, so I'm picking that up for him tomorrow in class, and if it works, I'm going to give him a big old hug. Oh god, someone's yelling. Oh, he's asking for me to put my clothes on. No, f*** you. Oh, okay. I don't know what I'm doing. Like I was saying, I lost my... Yeah, I'm gonna give him a hug if it does work. And I'll be kind of gay, but whatever. I'm no homo. No, it's a no homo hug, so it's fine. How about that? Okay, there you go. I think I got enough material to make an object to beat someone with. I don't know. But this security guard outfit, I'm going to put to use. And hopefully... Oh, God! He f***ing shot me! He f***ing shot me! What the hell? Okay. You're cool, buddy. You're cool, man. I lost, like, half my shit, so I guess I'm gonna end here. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys will consider picking up The Escapist. It's a really awesome game. And I hope you guys like my new Minecube series, because I started that. I want you guys' output. Apparently, you guys like it, because I got 10 likes. That's a milestone for me, so appreciate it. And I guess that's it, guys. And I will see you next time. Adios.